Hi, this is Priyank from Actronics India. In this video, we'll look into the IC74C922, which is a 16 matrix keypad decoder. So basically, here is our FreeDino, which is an Arduino Uno compatible. And this is our 4x4 16 keys matrix keypad. Now you wonder, we can directly connect this keypad matrix to this FreeDino. Why do we need a separate IC? First of all, if you want to directly connect this keypad to this FreeDino, you would require 8 pins. But using this IC, you'll require only 5 pins. But the real saving is not in terms of the number of pins on the Arduino board. The real saving is in terms of the program performance. In the normal traditional model where you connect the keypad matrix directly to your FreeDino, you would require to do polling of the keys. So your program is continuously busy in trying to do polling of the key state. But using this IC, you are freed up of this polling architecture, and instead you will use the interrupt based mechanism. It is the same mechanism which you use with the RF encoder decoder or the DTMF decoder circuit. So basically you connect the data available pin to the Arduino interrupt pin 2, 3, whichever you may like, and you connect the 4 data out pins to some Arduino digital IO pins to read the input state. These 4 pins correspond to the 4 bits, and this 4 bit will tell you a digit from 0 to 15 or 0 to F in hexadecimal, which will tell you like which of the keys has been pressed on this keypad matrix. So when the data is available, this pin will go high and an interrupt will generate, and in the interrupt handler you read this 4 bits using this 4 IO pins to get the value of the key pressed. Now in terms of connection, it is like very easy to connect this IC to the Arduino. The only components you require is 2 external capacitor. I have here used 0.1 microfarad, but every tutorial will suggest some or other value, but it would be almost in the same range. So basically you connect this 8 pins to this keypad decoder IC, and you connect the 4 data out pins to the Arduino and 1 data available pin to the Arduino interrupt. The rest of the pins except the VCC, you connect it to the ground, and the VCC you connect it to 5 volt, but it can take up to 3.3 volt to 15 volt this IC. So it's a like fairly wide range of operational voltage. So here you can see like we connect the 5-6 pins to the capacitor and the other side of the capacitor to the ground, and this is how you connect the 4 rows and 4 columns of the keypad, and this is how you connect the 4 data out and 1 data available pin to your microcontroller board, and the rest of the pins OE and ground you connect to the ground, and VCC we have connected here with 5 volt. So here we'll show you a quick demo of the program. So we'll press some keys. So as you have seen how easy it is to use this keypad decoder IC with this matrix keypad and your Arduino compatible board to read the key values being pressed. The benefit of this IC is not only from the programming side, but it frees you from using external pull-up pull-down resistors, from all those ghost clicks or the debouncing circuit. The data on the output pins are available for a longer time, so your microcontroller can read the data at its own pace. So for example, if you are making an MP3 player or you are making a security system or something like that, so the real task of an MP3 player is not to read the user input to play or stop. The real task of an MP3 player is like to play the music. Reading the user input is just a secondary thing, and So the number of user click in comparison to the total time of operation of the device would be too less. So it is ideal to use an interrupt based keypad interfacing to free up the microcontroller from doing other more priority tasks so that your audio might not lag and all those things. So instead of polling for the key press, your microcontroller will be automatically notified about any key press action event. So as you have seen how easy it is to use this IC with any microcontroller, I hope you like this video and you'll use this IC in one of your projects. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day.